Hello everyone, welcome to nithya.org, igniting innovations. In this video, we are going to set up Vagrant and VirtualBox on Windows platform. If you want to access the source code for this series, you can access via github.com/nithyananda. And also suggesting to visit my site nithya.org or nithya.io for any other information. What is Vagrant? Vagrant provides an easy way to configure reproducible and portable work environments built on top of industry standard technology and controlled by a single consistent workflow to help maximize the productivity and flexibility of you and your team. The Vagrant will isolate dependencies and their configuration within a single disposable consistent environment without sacrificing any of the tools you are used to working with, editors, browsers, debuggers, etc. See, Vagrant is nothing but it will provide the environment to play and deploy your applications, and you can test it, and also you can set up the environments and for dev, staging, even product pre-production environment. And also it supports, it can play with any other cloud vendors like AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud, or any other things. So it easily provides a consistent environment so that any developers have so much confidence before producing their application into the production environment. So we are going to see in action what is Vagrant, how to install it for the further actions. Next, what is VirtualBox? A VirtualBox is nothing but a hypervisor to virtualize your hardware into many logical pieces that can isolate your environment, and you can utilize your hardware in a better way. So as per VirtualBox site, you can see that VirtualBox is a powerful x86 and AMD 64, Intel 64 virtualization product for enterprises as well as home use. Not only is VirtualBox an extremely feature-rich, high-performance product for enterprise customers, it is also the only professional solution that is freely available as open-source software under the GNU Generic Public License version 2. And it's not only in running in Windows, it can run on Linux and Macintosh and Solaris host, and also it support large number of guest operating system including but not limited to Windows. And it is also a very unique product which to virtualize your hardwares in a such a way to accomplish many things. For example, you can run Ubuntu or you can run CentOS, you can run any other operating system, even Windows servers, you can do it. And then you can play it and you can virtualize your hardwares in a better way. So if you want to be with me in workshop, you should have laptop or desktop with Windows OS installed. And again, I'm telling, it's not only for Windows, you can do the same thing with Macintosh or Linux systems, but there is a small difference, which is because the package which I'm going to use it only for Windows, but it is very easy to follow this tutorial and you can apply the same thing with Macintosh or Linux systems. And the one more thing, you should enable the virtualization has to be at BIOS level. So you have to, you can switch on your operating system, you can switch on your laptop and press F5 or F9 according to your desktop or laptop environment. There will be the way to access your BIOS settings. There you have to enable the virtualization for Windows, for Intel or AMD 64. So that is very easy. You can easily follow some tutorials on online, but it is very easy and it is very doable. And also you should have internet connectivity. That is must, because we are going to access that binaries of Vagrant and Oracle VirtualBox from internet alone. I am not going to provide that binary from my GitHub. That is actually, I don't have rights to do that, but you should have internet connectivity. And also you should have administrator access, because you need a permission for as an administrator to enable virtualization, also installation permissions. Welcome to the demo, setting up Vagrant and Oracle VirtualBox. In this demo, we are going to install two binaries, which is one is Vagrant, another is Oracle VirtualBox. As the initial step, you have to visit in your browser called https://vagrantapp.com. Once you visit the site, you should see this page. It's a download section will directly come and you should click that download button. Once you reach the download, you should see the many distros of this version, which is according to the operating systems. As of now, we are using Windows as a host. So I am just concentrating on universal 32 and 64-bit binary. So I click over here and then it is going to ask to download Vagrant 1.8.6, that is the latest version as of today, as per October 23rd, 2016. And the size is coming around 167 MB. So please keep in mind, it is going to take your bandwidth little bit. So click save. And as of now, it is finished the downloading. So I'm going to open that the folder which is downloaded. So you can see that the Vagrant 1.8.6 MSI got downloaded. So double click the MSI. It is asking run as administrator. So security warning, please click run. And click next. And I'm going to agree that I accept the terms. Please read the README before accepting the terms and conditions, but I already read it. So click accept and click next. And then it is going to take basic download paths, C drive, HashiCorp and Vagrant. So you can change according to that. As of now, I'm just leaving as it is and click next and clicking install. It's not going to take much time. Now it's asking, you want to accept this installation, click yes, and it is going to install easily. And the time is getting varied because based on your hardware environment and the speed of the internet. So now it is copying in new files and is going to end up as soon as possible. So now the Vagrant has been installed successfully. Click finish and then it is asking you to restart your system. So please restart your system. As I'm clicking no, but you should restart the system and then you have to do the later point. And then once that it is Vagrant installed in your system, if you want to test whether Vagrant is installed successfully or not, please open your command prompt. Here actually I'm using a different command prompt because it is allowing us to play with the tabs and all. It is called conemu emulator. So I will do another session which is explaining what is the use of this conemu, but you can do with your normal Windows command prompt. So once it's open, then you can type Vagrant -- version. So it is going to search the execution path and it's going to explain what is the version which is you install in Vagrant. So now you should have get it Vagrant 1.8.6 version. So that is the latest version as of today. And if you type just Vagrant and help, you can see the numerous commands which is explain. It is very self-explanatory. Box, connect, destroy, and halt, login. There are many things is available and it is very self-explanatory. So this is your instance, but we are going to play with these commands as soon as possible. Once we install the Oracle VirtualBox, let's see. So now we have installed that Vagrant successfully. So I'm just closing this, minimizing the command prompt to play with it, or we can close this later. We come back. And the next command we are interested is actually Oracle VirtualBox. So you have to visit https://www.virtualbox.org. So once you enter into the site, so you will see this download page straight away. And then there is a big download VirtualBox 5.1 download button. So click over here. As of today, it's a 5.1 is the latest version. So I click over here. And then you can see as like Vagrant. So you are here also, you can see the many distros based on the operating system. So here you have Windows, here you have OS X, here you have Linux, you have Solaris host. So there are many binaries available. And here we are interested in Windows host. So I'm clicking over here, x86 and AMD64 binary, and it is asking to download it. And here you are getting it 5.1.8 is the version of the VirtualBox. And also it is asking you to download 116 MB, that is a 116 MB of download. So click save. And it is going to take little amount of time according to the bandwidth. So my bandwidth actually a 40 Mbps. So it might not take that much time. So it is depend on your network. There you go. It's downloaded successfully. And as of now, it is running a security scan from Norton. And here I'm going to click open folder, same folder. So you have that Oracle VirtualBox MSI 5.1.8 of 116 MB of size. And double click the same and click run. So now it clicks next. And then you must enable every part. So USB support is there, networking support will be there, and the host only network supporting will be there, and supporting for Python. If you don't want it, you can disable it, but I'm asking you to be with the default. But if you have any cross symbol, you should enable that also. And it is actually looking for C program files, Oracle VirtualBox path. Here also you can change your path according to the need. If you want to test disk usage, how much disk is going to take it, you can see it. Otherwise, click next. And then there are multiple options to interact. So I'm click next, be with the default, and proceed with the installation. Yes, click install, and then click yes over here. Keep in mind, so in this state you should enable the virtualizations already. Okay, as of now its installation is complete, and I'm going to start the Oracle VirtualBox after installation. Yes, click finish. So it is going to open the Oracle VirtualBox console. If you want to access the Oracle VirtualBox at the same time, you can go over here and then you type Oracle VirtualBox. It will be available here, or you can go to the little icon which is sitting over in the taskbar. So you can see that the Oracle VM VirtualBox manager is available for you. And then here you can click your virtual machines over here. But that we are not going to work alone with the VirtualBox. And so there are many ways to that. You can directly without Vagrant you can use it. But Vagrant will give you a consistent workflow process. So I'm asking you to follow the same, and I'm just minimizing the Oracle VirtualBox console. So now we have successfully installed VirtualBox and Vagrant. So now we are going to play with the Vagrant and install small operating system in that. And then let's see how it is going to work. Okay. So now I am opening that console command prompt to play with that Vagrant. So as I told already, so we are going to test what is the version now. Sorry, spelling mistake. Vagrant -version. So we got it. Vagrant 1.8.6. Yes, the another beautiful command. So Vagrant always work with the box format. So what is meant by box? Box is nothing but from HashiCorp, from the Atlassian cloud, it is going to provide the boxes. So you are able to see there is a box links, there is a boxes. So you can see that there are many boxes from different version. You can see that Ubuntu box is available in this box location. There is also got Precis 64, it's a standard Ubuntu 12.04 LTS, and there are many things. You can see it and you can search the boxes. Okay, so I'm going to search a boxes like called Bento. So what is my play take over here is Bento slash CentOS 7.1. So you are able to see one box called Bento 7.1. It is an awesome box. It is working very well, and there are many different distros from different community people, but I am suggesting you to go with that, or you can directly go with that Vagrant itself. U.7TOS. So you just search CentOS. There are many boxes. This is the official version of CentBox, which is called CentOS/7. So you can go with anything, but that the Bento 6 for CentOS 6.7 is actually CentOS 7.1. This version is actually the having some of the utilities which is installed by default. You can choose either of one, CentOS 7/1 or Bento 7.1. As of now, I'm going with the Bento CentOS 7.1 version. So once you understand your base box, okay, so you can go and initialize the boxes. So what is that? So box is nothing but an instance of the operating system which you want to play in your dev environment or staging environment or PP, whatever you want it. So it's providing the instance as a binary. So it's like actually compressed format. It will help you to install it. So before that, you can do Vagrant box list. So since my machine already have Bento CentOS 7.1, I have it Ubuntu Trusty 64, that is a 14.4 LTS version. So here you can see that what are the version it is supposed supported by the VirtualBox. Also you can see 2.2.2. So what I'm suggesting you, if it is not there, you can download it, but that automatically download based on your Vagrant commands, you will see it. So I am just declaring that. Now we are going to setting up the pure Vagrant Oracle VirtualBox. So I am telling the combination of Vagrant Oracle VirtualBox, because Vagrant is providing consistent workflow with the boxes, and Oracle is providing virtualization and virtualizing the hardware in a logical way, and then it's isolating your hardware. So that's what actually it is going to isolate your RAM usage. It is going to isolate your CPU usage, everything. Okay. So now we are going to play with this Vagrant boxes. So now I'm going to use it Vagrant. So for that, I'm going to create, I'm jumping to the D drive, and I'm going to create creating one directory, mkdir, and I can do a VM CentOS. Okay. So I'm going to create one VM using CentOS message. So I'm in D drive and CD VM CentOS. I'm inside that drive. Now I'm going to use this one of the boxes which I downloaded, but don't worry, it will automatically download if you don't have the box list. So you issue the command Vagrant init. Okay. Init will help you to create one of the important file for Vagrant. So the Vagrant is always works with the file called Vagrant file. So Vagrant init will create the file for you from that suggested box list. So I'm using it CentOS 7.1. You can use as you want. Okay. So I'm going to hit enter. So what is going to do it? It is going to create the file. So you can see that a Vagrant file has been placed in this directory. You are now ready to Vagrant up your first virtual environment. Okay. So it is very easy to do that. So now I'm going to see the file. So I'm going to see the dir. There is a file called Vagrant file is created for you because of the Vagrant init command. So now I'm going to see that Vagrant file. So for that, I'm using Sublime text. So I'm going to the D drive and VM CentOS and select the folder. and opening the file called Vagrant file. Here you can see that the Vagrant file is listed. So there are many things which is commented, because if you wanted to use it, you can uncomment it. So, but as of now, we are going to not, I'm not going to explain every features of Vagrant, but it will help you to get started. The first thing is the first line, which you can see it, the Vagrant version, we are using two version. That's what Vagrant configure to, and then do. The do is actually loop. If you see that do, and then you can see that there is an end command. So you can see the end. So it's a do loop, and you are going to learn much things on upcoming sessions. And so this is the first do loop we are doing it. Here we are telling that, hey, what box I need to use it as a base image. The base image is we are using is CentOS 7.1. So that is this one. And another things, so everything is commented other than that, because it's a very bare minimum VM boxes, but I'm suggesting go through the different commands. So first commands I am like to explain called configure VM network and private network IP. So what it does, this line is going to put this IP and attach this IP to the Vagrant machine. Okay. And the same way, what you can do it, you can do the same thing with public IP. So just you change it to, instead of private, you can copy and paste it. So you can do public IP. So public network IP 192.168.33.10. So you can attach that public IP as well as private IP with these lines. And another very important thing, you should enable the configuration, how much GB of RAM you have to use it for your things. Because if you see my computer, so you can see it, I have 28 GB of RAM in my workstation, as well as it's a 64-bit operating system, and I have 8-core CPU actually. So I have 8-core CPU. You can see that 4 cores and 4 logical processors. So you can see much. So according to that, how we are going to decide your actually the size of the image and everything you can decide over here. So you have to uncomment these lines. So again, we are starting inside the do loop. Inside the, again, we are starting do loops. What we are doing it here? So we are telling that, so we are using VB and then VirtualBox GUI equal to true. And then we are going to tell that VB memory, which is 1 GB, we are going to allocate it, correct? By default, it is going to allocate 1 GB, or you can change it 2048, that is 2 GB, 4096 is a 4 GB, correct? So you can allocate the memory as like you want. But so I'm going back, I'm going to simplify everything. So I'm not going to use anything. I'm going to put that very bare minimum things as init file is created. So I'm just clicking save. I'm not going to do anything over there. So I'm using the same boxes which is coming with it. Okay. Now what I have done it, you can see the VirtualBox, nothing is over here. And then I'm just going back to the same thing. I'm naming only one directory called Vagrant file. Now I'm going to issue the command called Vagrant up. What it will do, Vagrant up is going to initiate your box file to the Vagrant Oracle virtual box. So what it does actually, it will take, it's like an ISO file. It is going to install as a OS and it will give you a prompt of logging. So, and here I'm using headless CentOS VM. So it is not going to have any UI. There is no graphical user interface, because it will save my lot of space as well as lot of performance issues, and everything is actually will be good. But if you like to work with that GUI, you have to go for other box version. So as of now, I'm using CentOS 7.1 version. So I'm going to initialize now. So I'm just hitting enter in the same directory. I'm going to issue the command called Vagrant up. So it is going to download the boxes from the internet, or if you have the boxes inside your host machine, so automatically it is going to take the boxes. And also it is going to enable a NAT. NAT is nothing but network address translation. That means your host internet will be shared to the virtual box. So that's what it is doing it. And also you can enable forwarding ports. So that means you can forward your any interaction from host to virtual machine and get the response back. And another thing, so you can use 22 to log into the virtual boxes, so that you can do it. And then the SSH username, if you want to log into the virtual box, you have to use Vagrant as the virtual box. And also it is using a private key as the authentication mechanism. So you can use it, this private key by default, and it will be used for authenticating yourself. And you can see that there is a called machine booted ready, and there is a guest edition version is 5.0 is available for you. And also there is a folder actually which is synced from host machine to your Oracle VirtualBox. That means whatever you are putting in D drive VM CentOS folder, it can be taken from the path of /vagrant in Linux machine. So now we have successfully actually done that listing. So you can see Vagrant box list once again. So you can see the boxes. If we already seen it, but if you are doing first time, you can, the boxes will be listed over here, and your box is ready. So now we go back to that Oracle VirtualBox and see whether the box is in running state. Yes, you can see over here it is a VM CentOS. That is actually a folder name, and the default is actually a name which the name is which is given in the file. You can see over here in the Vagrant file, you are giving the name called, because you didn't give the name over here, so it is taken as the default, but you can define the name of the file and name of the virtual box. So VM send is a folder name, default is the name which you provide. If you are not providing the VM machine, it is automatic by default. And there is another ID which is giving, that is called box ID. So the box ID will be attached to the every VMs. So you can see that. And if you want to see how the section, click that setting section. So here everything you send, where the box is actually hosted. You can see the storage section, and then you can click the VMDK file. That is a VMDK file is nothing but virtual machine disk file, which is actually, it is in the location of C users and username and the virtual box VMs, and your VM file will be there. So let's explore where is that. So PC, C, users, my username is Babu over here, and VirtualBox VMs is a folder, and you can see that the same machine which is hosted here, VM CentOS default, and here you can see that there is a box file and as well as your virtual machine disk file, correct? So everything is actually is there, and the, all the logs will be over here. So how to hardening and all the things will be available over here. So now we have successfully actually created the virtual machines with the configurations. And as well as you have to notice one thing called network. Is it? So network, if you want to enable the internet, you have to do manually, but with the Vagrant facility, it is automatically creating the NAT facility, that is network address translation, and it does the port forwarding for SSH 22 port. So that means if you are doing it from the SSH 222, that is a 4 tools, and if you see that, you can go inside the guest boxes. So we are not going to use the SSH login, because you should have that PuTTY or some kind of a Linux utility to go inside it. But we are going to use Vagrant itself to launch into the, go into the system. So let's see how to do it. So now I'm in the same folder, and you can see, understand, there is a file. If you see the dir, there is a file called .vagrant folder, which is created. What is mean .vagrant folder? You can see that VM CentOS, there's a .vagrant folder is here. There is a folder called machines. In the same machine, there is a machine called default, and then VirtualBox, and all the configurations which is located over here. What is the ID it needs to give? What is the private key to authenticate your host to the boxes? Everything is located here. It will read from here only. Okay, so now you understand what is called dot vagrant folder, and we are going inside that VirtualBox, because you can do the same thing in two ways. Go to the Oracle VirtualBox or double click it, and you can see the logins, localhost login. But that this is cumbersome to handle because a very small screen. I don't want to, because we didn't install any guest edition over here, so it will not go. It is not going to give a big box thing either. But now I'm going to use Vagrant facility itself to login. So I'm just clicking minimize it, going over here, and going inside the box using Vagrant itself. So for that, Vagrant SSH, okay, the box name. I can do, because since I am inside the box, I don't require to do give anything. Click enter. So you can see over here you are inside the CentOS machine. So you can see that Vagrant is the username, the host name is localhost. Correct? So now you are inside the machine. If you want to see, you have a better kernel, so you can put uname -r. It is going to tell that you are using 3.10 is the Linux kernel. So it is the very latest one, so it will work everything over here. So you can test now whether the internet is connected or something, correct? So you can do the two ways. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use yum install something, correct? So as of now, there is no nano over here. So nano is the text-based editor, which I like most. So I'm going to try install from the internet. What I'm going to do is to yum install nano -y. So what it's going to do is it is going to communicate to that CentOS repository, and is going to download the nano. Click enter. Let's see. So, and also you need to have the sudo permission. Sudo yum install nano -y. So it is going to communicate to the internet and is going to download it and run it as a service. Let's see. Yes, I hope we have internet access, because the Vagrant is enabling that NAT interface. So it is downloading it successfully. So you have that internet in your system. You can play, interact in the outside world. So that's the beauty of this box. So it is going to take little amount of time. Yes, so we got nano installed in our system. That means the internet is working successfully. Let's test the utility. So I'm going to do nano hello world. So it's opened the editor. It's a very awesome editor I like. So there are more editors like vi. There is a, if you want to see the text, you can use cat. Many things are there. I'm just do hello world. How are you? So this text I am putting it. So you want to use it, control X, and then it's asking you want to modify. Click Y, then you write the file. So now I'm going to do that cat hello world. Yes. So you can see that hello world, how are you? So you can use even, you can use nano hello world only. So you can see that, sorry. Nano hello world. So you can see the editor back. Control X, it'll, you can go back. So this explains you have successfully launched virtual machine with Vagrant and Oracle VirtualBox, correct? So, and so once you install, once you go inside, if you want to exit, you can come exit, click exit. So you can, you are logging out from the machine, and then your connection is closed. Okay, so now we have boxes. Suppose you don't want the boxes in your list, so you want to destroy. This is where the Vagrant actually is putting that very consistent workflow. So whenever you want it, you can do it, or whenever you want it, you can just destroy. What is it? Vagrant destroy will help you to destroy the entire machine which is hosted. So it is asking, do you want to destroy? Click S. So it is going to shutting down the VM and destroying the VM under associated. So it is going to delete entire drives for you. And then you can go over here. You can see that there is no boxes over here. So you created that VMs. And then once you played, once you do the development, or if you want to destroy, you just send the destroy command. If you want to play all the commands, there is easily a self-explanatory. do vagrant slash help hyphen help. So you can do many things over here. And one more exercise I am going to do it, setting up the public IP of the system. So let's for it. So again, I'm going to the Vagrant file over here. Okay, so here I'm going to do that configuring that IP of the machine, correct? So what do you, for that, what you have to do is actually, you are going to do that configuring public network. So I'm going to do config, I'm enabling config VM network, public network, then comma IP colon, and then I'm going to do 192.168.0.100. Okay, so I'm going to put this IP as a public IP. So let's see how it is going to attach this IP and then how we can use this IP from the host. Okay, so I'm going to click save, nothing but I just enabled, and I'm just enabled the public network and IP, and let's minimize it, and then I'm going over here. So one more command I want to do is called vagrant status. So if you do that vagrant status, it's going to tell that your configuration file is correct. Okay, and the what is the vagrant file name is called default, and it is status is not created. So that's what you can see it. Now I'm going to use vagrant app again. Okay. Okay, now vagrant got provisioned. So let's see, I'm going to clear the screen again, going to vagrant SSH. So you can use that machine name or call. So now I'm having a version called default, or you can use it because since you have inside the boxes, correct? So I'm doing vagrant SSH default. Okay, fine. So now we need to see which our IP, whatever we mentioned over in the file, call 192.168.0.100 is actually provisioned or not. So yes, so for that you do IP ADDR then show. Okay, so what it display is actually, what are the interfaces actually attached to the system? You can see that there is a loopback address, which is a default is 127.00.1. Yes, that is the one of the IP. And another IP is a private IP, is called 10.0.2.15. That is the IP which is by default attached to every private system. And here, this is the IP which we actually provision, called 192.168.1.100. That is we have mentioned over here, correct? We have mentioned is 192.16.0.100. This is the interface. And also another Ethernet, which is actually provisioned by DHCP protocol, which is 192.161.0. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 interfaces which is attached with the system. So you can attach as many IPs you wanted, but that always please limit your private and IPs and public IPs, because so it is prone to security attack. So now we have achieved that things, but what if I running some services over here, how the outside world can access it? As of now, you cannot access this box outside, correct? So for example, I'm going to install one Apache server. So yum. So I'm going to use sudo yum install http, that is Apache server, Tomcat server. So it is going to install it. Okay, now we have installed the Apache Tomcat servers, and it is, let's now I'm going to see that whether it is installed perfectly or not. So for that I'm going to use sudo systemctl and status httpd, correct? So it is telling the status which is installed, but it is inactive and dead. So now I'm going to start the services, like instead of status, I'm going to tell that start. So now again, I'm going to do the status. So you can see that their servers is running or actively and running. Okay. So now I'm going to test this whether the server is running or not perfectly. So now I'm going to do use curl http localhost. You can see that there is an Apache file is sitting over here. But if you take the same case, correct? So you have that Apache is running inside the virtual machine. But do one thing, go to your browser, and you know that is running an IIT. So can you do it like this? Because since it's a public IP, you see that HTTP localhost, sorry, not localhost, 192.168.0.100. Correct. But it is not going to show anything over the here, because the problem is, so the host will not connect directly unless until you are providing the port forwarding for you that. So now you want to do is actually you are not able to accessible, and then you have to do so much thing to work. You have to change that firewall. You have to change the IP address and all. So easy way to do it, I'm going to do coming exit out. So I'm going to access, I'm going to do the same thing, but that how would I'm going to achieve it? Okay. So now I'm going back to this VM box. Okay, so I'm going to enable one thing called port forwarding it. So I'm going to enable this line called config.vm.network called forwarded port. That is actually feature which we are going to exhibit. So guess why I'm actually we are running an 80, and then the host is we are going to run it 8080. Okay, so let's keep the same way. So guest is actually, you know, Apache Tomcat is going to run over here, and host is going to run in 8080. Okay, so I'm going to enable it. I'm going to save it over here, and the file is saved. So I'm going to issue one command call. I already logged out from that. I'm going to issue the command called vagrant halt. Vagrant halt, what it does is actually it is going to shut down your machine. So it is gracefully shutdowning your machine. So it is going to close some process which is running, which already you might run some process. It is going to shutdowning that. So now, since I already the file, you can see that I already the file this line, and I saved the file also. You can close this and test it. Yes, it is saved successfully. Correct. So now I'm going to, okay, so I open that. Let me go to the folder. What we do is VM in CentOS, and I am inside the machine. So now we already done the vagrant halt. Now we are going to again vagrant up the same machine, but it is going to take the file again back. So here you can see some changes which is already. So you can see that it is clearing that. Clearing any previously set forward post, because it's going, because we did alt and again we are coming up. Here there is a line is added. See that over here. Vagrant 80 guest and then 8080 on host. Correct? So that means whatever you are hitting in from local host, that is from host machine 8080, it is going to forward the request to the 80 port which is running in the guest. For us, it's actually it's a CentOS machine, correct? So now once it's provisioned, I'm going back and see that whether it is working from host machine or not. Okay, let's see it. Yes. So I have provisioned. I'm going to do that vagrant SSH. Okay, so I am inside the machine. Let's see IP ADDR show. We should have that 0.100 machines. Yes, it is already there. Fine. Okay. And what we are going to do, chest test called. Before that, chest the status. Sudo system ctl status. HTTPD. Since we would the service has not become active again, so that's what I tested that. So you do instead of status, you do start. Yes, is done, and see the status. Yes, actively running. So that means and test which is accessible locally. Yes, curl HTTP localhost. Yes, it's running. So now I'm clearing it. I'm going back in host. I did one mistake. So I need to try 8080 port. Enter it. Whether the port forwarding is working or not. But it will not work because we are trying with the machine of that center. So what you have to do is localhost 8080. Yes, it's working. So localhost 8080, which is running on CentOS and which is running HTTP Apache server, because you understand now. So you are entering in localhost, that is your host machine, which is Windows, and you are typing 8080, and that 8080 actually is going to get forwarded to this things which is running over here, correct? So that's the page actually testing 1, 2, 3, which is coming from the box. So if you are not confident enough, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to stop this Apache server. I'm just state entering it. So I did that. So again, click enter. You will see that there is a, we can't reach the page because we shut down in the virtual machines. Now I'm going to start it. Now just refresh it, your page has come up. So you are able to do the networking from host to your CentOS VM. So that's the beauty of this, the port forwarding it. So these are the things without touching this Oracle VirtualBox settings, you are doing everything from the Vagrant file. So you can achieve many things over here from this Vagrant. There are so many things you can explore. If you want to explore more things, go to your Ashikop system called vagranthub.com, and you go for the docs, and then you can get the getting started and command line interface. It will help you to explain what are the commands is for halt, what are the commands for, what is the use of box, everything you can see that. So as I told, we have used list, we didn't use add, updated. So please explore. If you click each and every link, you can explore more things. For example, what is the add functionality? How to use it? So you can see everything over here. What are the options you can provide whenever executing the commands? Everything you can see it over here. So thank you for watching. Correct. So I hope it is an enjoyable session which we played in Vagrant Oracle VirtualBox. And then these sessions will help you to play with many other things, like while explaining CentOS, while explaining console services, while explaining Amazon Cloud. So it will help you to, because we are going to play with Vagrant and Oracle Jobs. So this will be a base video which will help in multiple workshops. So that's what I want to concentrate to, specially dedicated for how to set up the Vagrant Oracle VirtualBox. So thanks for watching. Appreciate it. If you want to access any code base for the video series, you can go github.com/nithyananda, and please sign up my newsletter via nithya.org/signup. And also, if you want to interact with me, please send a mail to info@nithya.org. Have a great day. Thanks.